Hi guys, Specialist here with another Overwatch character breakdown. Today's character is Genji, or aka the Warframe looking character. He's a freaking ninja. Genji is one of my favorite looking characters in Overwatch, but he is also one of the hardest ones to use. His first ability, which is his passive, is he's the same as Hanzo, where he can climb walls and he can do a double jump, which Hanzo can't. If you know how to use his double jump and his shurikens, he is probably close to or even harder to hit than even Tracer, if you know how to use that. So he is a level 3 difficulty, and it's for good reason, because he is hard to use and he's hard to hit. His primary weapon of choice is his shurikens. He shoots them in two different ways. One, he shoots them straight, like he goes. Like, if you're familiar with, like, pulse rifles in, like, Destiny or Call of Duty, you go, he shoots them three. But they do have, like, a good delay on them. So, you're supposed to use them more, like, anticipating where they're going, right? Or if they're coming directly at you. But they do have a travel time, so you have to predict where they're going to go. But then he has two modes of it. One, like I said, he shoots forward, and there's one, he shoots them spread out. This spread out is more when they're close to you, the enemies, like when they're like right up in your face. So, example for like Reinhardt, he's a big dude. You might want to use the regular shuriken, the one that shoots in a straight line. But if he's all up in your face, or even like with the Tracer, you can at least try and land one of them, because one shuriken does a good amount of damage. So if it spreads out, it's easier for you to get at least one of them to land. So just play with those. His first ability is Swift Strike. This is a dash, he goes forward, and actually if you end up killing them, it resets instantly. And you can also use this to get like on top of buildings and stuff like that, because there's no like gravity. So if you aim up, you'll go straight up. But in the video you're probably gonna see now, it used to have overtime damage. So once you hit them, it starts like ding ding, it starts hitting them a little. It doesn't have that anymore. So what it does is just go straight and hits them once. That's all it does. It's not as strong as it used to be, but it's still okay. This is very good because it travels a good ass distance to hit the dude. You hit them with the shuriken a little, and right before they get away from you, you boom, get that. And once you kill them with it, you'll get it instantly right back. His second ability is called Deflect. Pretty much what it says, it deflects incoming damage. It used to be able to deflect Hanzo's dragon arrows. It doesn't do it anymore, for my experience. This is Bastion's worst nightmare. You can literally get up in front of Bastion, ding, block all them shits, and it kills them instantly. As fast as you can kill others, you can kill him as well. So this can pretty much block anything. Only thing it can't deflect is lasers. Anything involving lasers, it will not deflect. Any projectiles, missiles, anything, it will project, besides laser type things. So keep that in mind. That's very good to run away with. Learn how to use it properly, because that's one of his biggest strengths, is his blocking or deflect. His Dragon Blade is his ult. This ult is a melee only ult. It increases like his speed, so he moves a little faster. So the one thing I don't like about this ult, because it allows you to do anything from his ability. You can still use his Shift Strike and his deflect. You can still do that, but you do that melee. It does a good amount of damage. But what I don't personally like about it is that it doesn't one-shot Tracer. In the video that you'll probably see, you'll see that it one-shots her, but it doesn't anymore. It does not one-shot her anymore. It takes two shots to kill a Tracer. That's very weak, in my opinion. But if you use it with, like, Maze Freezing ult, or you use it with that female tank, the one that pulls the black hole, if you use it with those, it can be deadly. Because the blade or his melee will hit multiple people. If it have like a good like range to it, so you can hit more than one person at a time. So knowing a little bit about Genji, real quick, I pretty much broke down what I think about his abilities. But he is a very up-in-your-face character. He can deflect a lot, but he's more of a flanker as well. Most of the characters in Overwatch are flankers. I'm just saying that right now, flanking pretty much means you get behind them without them noticing you, because Genji, he can die really fast, but he has a lot of things that can prevent him from dying. Sort of like his deflect and his shift strike, which gets you away from the danger. But it took me a while to actually do good with him because he is difficult to use. Especially his shurikens are very hard to land. So my best bet, not my best bet, but the best thing I can tell you is you gotta go up close. Because the travel time on the shurikens are so slow, I think that it should be much faster. But because they're so slow, you should get closer to your opponents. So that's pretty much my breakdown on Genji. If you guys enjoyed the video, please hit that like and subscribe. It helps my channel grow. And yeah, thank you for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Peace.